What's up, guys? Today, we're finally talking about the top 7 ideas from Tools of Titans. This book is a little different than others, because this book is actually a collection of interviews and information from 123 very successful people. So instead of breaking down every single person in the book, I decided to read the book and find the common traits that most of them have in common. I found 7, and I'm sure there's more. So let's get started. Common trait number 1, they all had mentors. Arnold Schwarzenegger, who by the way wrote the foreword of this book, says that he is not a self-made man. He says that to get where he is, he had to stand on the shoulders of giants. He had a vision, but if it wasn't for his parents teaching him to work harder, or coaches showing him the basics of weightlifting, or someone teaching him about business, he would not have become who he desired. That is why he says that he is not self-made. That gives the wrong impression that he did it all alone. Common trait number 2. Morning routines and rituals. I'm sure you hear everywhere about morning routines and how the most successful people do them. But have you ever wondered why? Why do people do morning routines? Why does it work? One of my personal mentors says that it is not much about the things you do, but the momentum you create. Small wins create momentum. For example, let's say that you wake up in the morning and you make your bed. Check. You go drink a glass of cold water. Check. You do 40 push-ups. Check. You meditate for about 10 minutes. Check. And then you read 5 pages of a really good book. Check. And let's say that that takes you about 35 to 40 minutes. After those 35 minutes, you have already accomplished 5 things and you are on fire. You will have a lot more momentum than if you just woke up and checked social media from bed for 30 minutes. Bonus. A lot of people use physical exercise in their morning routines to physically activate their bodies. Because when you wake up, you're still kind of sleepy and tired, but once you exercise a little, your body wakes up. Common trait number 3. Most practice a form of meditation or mindfulness. Usually part of their morning routine, most, about 80% of world-class performers interviewed, practice a form of meditation or mindfulness. I'll give you a few examples. Tim Ferriss, for example, he uses a form of meditation to step back and gain a witness perspective. Think about a war, and then think about observing it from a hilltop. You can see the whole battlefield, the whole map. Now you can see the bigger picture, and you can make high-level decisions. Tony Robbins, he uses another form of meditation to elicit the emotions that he wants to have throughout the day. He first focuses on being grateful for everything, even for simple things, like the wind in your face, or the sunshine, or the reflection of the clouds. Tony says that you cannot be angry or have negative emotions when you feel grateful. Common trait number 4. They invest in themselves. When Tony Robbins was asked, "What is the biggest investment that you've ever made?" he responded, "A $35 3-hour gym run seminar when he was 17. When Tony asked Warren Buffett the same question, Buffett said, "His biggest investment was a public speaking course he took from Dale Carnegie." Yes, the guy who wrote How to Win Friends and Influence People. So whether your goal is to create good habits or develop your social skills or make more money, you are your most valuable asset. So investing in yourself will be the most important investment you make. Common trait number 5, they take action. After Warren Buffett took Dale Carnegie's public speaking course, he immediately went to the University of Omaha and asked if he could teach. Jim Rohn once said, "If you let your learning lead to knowledge, you become a fool. But if you let your learning lead to action, you become wealthy." It's like having an idea. The idea itself won't do anything, but taking action on that idea will. Common trait number 6, consistency. Mastery doesn't come from what we know or even what we do. Taking action once is not enough. Mastery comes from what we do consistently. Arnold Schwarzenegger wouldn't have become the best bodybuilder of all time if he went to the gym once a week. He did it consistently. Casey Neistat wouldn't be as successful as he is if he didn't put a video every day for 534 days. If there's a secret to success, this would be it. Consistency is what truly makes a difference. Common trait number 7, they work hard. Taking action consistently is no easy task. It takes a lot of work. Let's think about Casey Neistat. A video a day might not sound as impressive until you see a day in his life. Casey would wake up at 4:30 a.m. 7 days a week and finish editing his video vlog from the day before. He finishes the video between 6:30 and 7 a.m. From 7 to 7:45 a.m., the video would process and upload to YouTube. Every day, for 534 days, the daily vlog went live at exactly 8 a.m. Then he works out immediately after 8 a.m., usually running. He goes into the office by 9:30 a.m., and he works all day blogging and in his company, and tries to get out by 6:30 p.m. so he can give his baby a bath. He then would spend time with his wife until she goes to sleep around 9:30 p.m., and then he begins editing his blog for the next day until around 1 a.m. He then would go to sleep and wake up at 4:30 a.m. and repeats the whole process again. Alright guys, hope you enjoyed the video. This book is like a Swiss knife for entrepreneurs, and it's filled with tools and ideas for all kinds of different situations. So I definitely recommend the book. If you want to get the book through me, I got the link below. If not, it's cool, but definitely get your hands on the book. Also, don't forget to subscribe and click that little bell button so you won't miss out on all the new videos coming out soon. And trust me, we got a lot of good stuff coming. Alright, until next time, I'll see you guys in the next video.